the U.S. Air Force could develop a nuclear-armed hypersonic boost glide vehicle with a range equivalent to a traditional intercontinental ballistic missile, or ICBM. This system may potentially go on top of the future ground-based strategic deterrent, or GBSD, ICBMs, which aims to replace America's existing and aging nuclear-tipped LGM-30G Minuteman III intercontinental ballistic missile. Till now, it was perceived that hypersonic weapons programs being pursued by different branches of the U.S. military are all conventionally armed. Air Force Lieutenant General Richard Clark, the Deputy Chief of Staff for Strategic Deterrence and Nuclear Integration, said in response to a specific question about a potential nuclear-armed hypersonic payload during a virtual event hosted by the Air Force Association's Mitchell Institute on August 19, 2020, GBSD does have an open architecture. It gives us an ability to incorporate emerging technologies we need to counter whatever threats we face in the future. So as we bring the system, GBSD, online, we will ensure that we have the ability to roll different technologies in and incorporate that into GBSD. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. plans to counter Russian and Chinese air defenses with a hypersonic glide vehicle nuclear-tipped missile. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, that's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, which is 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. The first is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missile to reach hypersonic speeds. The scramjet engine can power a hypersonic cruise missile. The second is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but is launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which are launched from land or sea-based platforms. The third is using HGV, or hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using ballistic missile or an aircraft, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. This approach could be used in ground-based strategic deterrent, ICBM, where traditional warheads will be replaced by HGV. Countries like Russia and China have been developing sophisticated layered air defense. These systems may be difficult for traditional aircraft and missiles to penetrate. Traditional ballistic missiles like LGM-30 Minuteman III also reach hypersonic speed of more than Mach 20 when it descends down on the target, but it follows a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which could lead to possible interception by modern anti-ballistic missile defense systems. Cruise missiles can maneuver when flying towards a target, but have way less speed. This makes them vulnerable to interception. They also have limited range, making them unsuitable for use in a strategic role. Because of the latest air defenses, MAD equilibrium could be compromised. Mutually assured destruction, or MAD, is a doctrine of military strategy and national security policy in which a full-scale use of nuclear weapons by two or more opposing sides would cause the complete annihilation of both the attacker and the defender. Because of this, no country risks the use of nuclear weapons on another one which can retaliate with nukes. Hypersonic weapons are seen as a way to circumvent air defense and maintain mad equilibrium. Their extreme speed and ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a high probability of penetrating the air defenses. They'll be very hard to track, let alone intercept. This makes them apt for neutralizing well-defended strategic military assets from long ranges, as well as act as nuclear deterrents. Russia has claimed it has operationally deployed hypersonic boost glide vehicle named Avangard. In 2018, during the State of the Nation address, President Putin had unveiled several new weapons, and one of them was Avangard. At that time, Mr. Putin had described it by saying, "It heads to target like a meteorite, like a fireball." Avangard's last test was on the 26th of December. For the test, Avangard was deployed onboard a UR-100 UTT-KH ICBM. It was launched from the Dumbarovsky missile base in the Ural Mountains and hit a target at the Kura missile test range. Yuri Borisov, the Deputy Prime Minister of Russia, stated a day later on Russian TV channel that the missile flew at 27 times the speed of sound. That's Mach 27. As per reports, Avangard is designed using advanced composite materials so it can withstand and operate at temperatures up to 2,000 degrees Celsius, which is attained when an object flies through the atmosphere at hypersonic speeds. The weapon can carry a nuclear warhead of up to 2 megatons. To give viewers a perspective, here's a comparison. The Trinity test in New Mexico in July 1945, which ushered in the nuclear age, had a yield of 20 kilotons. Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. The Russian Defense Ministry said that it had demonstrated the Avangard to a team of U.S. inspectors as part of transparency measures under the New START nuclear arms treaty between the two countries. China is thought to be pursuing hypersonic weapons as well. It had shown off mock-ups of its Road Mobile DF-17 as part of the October 2019 celebrations commemorating the 70th anniversary of the founding of the People's Republic of China. Though current U.S. doctrine aims to keep hypersonic weapons for conventional strike only, a path has been kept open for changes. Kingston Reef, the Director for Disarmament and Threat Reduction Policy at the Arms Control Association, a nonpartisan organization that works to promote public understanding of and support for effective arms control policies, pointed out on Twitter that President Donald Trump's administration's 2018 Nuclear Posture Review included passages that could indicate an interest in nuclear-armed hypersonic developments. That policy document stated, "DoD will explore prioritization of existing research and development funding for advanced nuclear delivery system technology and prototyping capabilities. This will support the U.S. development of hedging options and focus, as necessary, on the rapid development of nuclear delivery systems, alternative basing modes, and capabilities for defeating advanced air and missile defenses." Current air defense could be overwhelmed with traditional nuclear-tipped missiles, but things could change as more and more improvement is made. Russia is working on the S-500 air defense system that could be very good at intercepting traditional ballistic missiles. It also has made progress on PRS-1M. The PRS-1M is a new hypersonic interceptor developed by Russia as part of the A-135 missile defense system. It will act as a replacement for the 53TS endo-atmospheric interceptor. The 53TS was a short-range interceptor designed to intercept intermediate-range ballistic missiles, whereas PRS-1M is designed to neutralize even intercontinental ballistic missiles. It's clear that going forward, these air defense systems may force the development of HGV nuclear tip missiles, and it's wise for the US to slowly pave its way in this direction.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.